Thank you, Mr. Chairman, members of the committee. House Bill 1527, I just want to give a real brief context. For the members' information, steel slag is a byproduct of the steelmaking process. As everyone here pretty much knows, steelmaking is one of the largest recycling operations in the Commonwealth. The products and the byproducts are pretty much all utilized. Since the 1930s, steel slag has been used as a safe, effective, and inexpensive road aggregate in Pennsylvania and the United States. In 2008, because of a few road failures, PennDOT districts 9, 12, and 11 have concluded that slag was the culprit of the road failures. When they came to that conclusion, they brought no forensic evidence to the table. And since then, no forensic evidence has been substantiated those claims. As a result of their claims, these three PennDOT districts have essentially taken slag off the table for usage in road construction. The steel industry, if they can't use the slag for road construction, they actually landfill it. It's no longer a recycled product then. What has happened is because these districts have taken, they have basically put a note in their proposal for a request for road construction that puts a moisture requirement on the slag. This moisture requirement is something that's unattainable by the material. Slag can't meet the requirements, so it's basically been pulled off of the table for usage in road-based construction. Study after study that has studied the issues on these road failures have concluded that it's not an issue of the slag. Water is the culprit of the road failures. When water gets underneath the roadbed, it creates this heaving that we see on all of our roads. Very briefly, what House Bill 1527 does is it creates a uniformity in the request for bid for construction projects. It just basically says that PennDOT cannot simply take one aggregate, specifically steel slag, off the table for uses in road construction. The bill requires the department to create, disseminate uniform standards for what types of slags are acceptable. It does not mandate the usage of steel slag, and that's essentially what the bill does, and I'd be happy to answer any questions.